put some zeros in the bank. Show you how to make them pay attention when they ain't. Say what they gonna do, but they don't do it cause they can't. Make them bounce, rock, shake. Dance on a plate, call it strawberry cake. Try to set my plate, sorry you a little late. Tell them one time, baby, I don't like to wait. Wake up, walk out fresh. New on deck, bust down Paget. Better have my check, better come correct. I might crush a mini-me if I don't watch my step. I don't really know what you came for. I'm here to milli double up, really stack my dough. Sky pulley up, in the vent of dough. Gotta send it like tic-tac-toe. I be laced up in Louis, just left from Gucci. Bougie and I'm choosy, ooh. Dip down in Prada, got it from my dada. Hustle like my mama, ooh. Make a bounce, rock, shake. I'ma show you how to put some zeros in the bank. Show you how to make them pay attention when they ain't. Say what they gon' do, but they don't do it cause they can't. Make a bounce, rock, shake. Hands on a plate, call it strawberry cake. Try to stop my play, sorry you a little late. Tell them one time, baby, I don't like to wait. It's a tune-up,
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
The bronze likeness of Lakers great Magic Johnson that can be found just outside the front door of our location today, the Staples Center. Welcome everybody to another presentation of the NBA live on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, joined by our analysts Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke. Plus, reporting from the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. D.A., it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Paul George has shown over the years that he remains one of the most versatile stars in the league. He said, "I pride myself on being effective on both ends. I try to do it all, play the right way, and just get lost in the game. I'll do everything I can to win." And guys, there's still not much he can't do with his combination of size and athleticism.
David, he clearly is a special talent, and his resume shows. Thank you. So here's Oklahoma City's starting group. Sliding into the wing spots, Gilgeous Alexander and Dort. And it's the dude, then there's Favors, and it's Roby in at the four. And for the Clippers, outside the wings are George and Leonard. The post pairing, Batum and Zubats. And it's Jackson in at the one. And Doris, here we are, the final day of the regular season. What has surprised you most from this year?
You know, one of the most exciting things for me is the players who take those huge leaps in their play, and a team maybe that hasn't lived up to expectations or the ones that have exceeded expectations.
Favors with the ball, guarded now by Jackson. The shot's good from Gilgeous Alexander.
Great concentration through the contact. Gilgeous Alexander, excellent focus.
Here's Batum. Doesn't go that time. And Oklahoma City will go with it the other way. The last encounter was in Oklahoma City.
And they got the better of this matchup last time with their defensive pressure and the ability to force turnovers.
Yeah, I thought the giveaways were a tremendous factor. They were taking some chances on D, jumping in the passing lanes, that sort of thing. And it really paid off for them.
You know Jackson can just fly. I mean, that athleticism and energy is off the charts.
Gilgeous Alexander against Zubats. Off the left rim and out. And it's the Clippers' ball. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
Yeah, and that one, unbelievable shooting display, especially from long range. That turned out to be the difference.
Well, and I think what that was a product of was their movement off the basketball. Just tremendous work on the perimeter.
love seeing a point guard who can explode to the rim like that.
Oh, great attitude and even a better finish.
Boy, it's incredible how much explosive scoring ability can come from the lead guard position. That is a big-time play.
Down low, here's Favors, and a slam dunk by Favors.
If Derek Favors gets deep post position, it's over. He's going to leave, no doubt, on the flush.
Clippers have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Jackson looking around, connects from three-point range. Jackson's got 5 points so far.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
And there's the fouls on Nicholas Batum. That's his first foul. His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
The pass to Roby. Leonard against Dort. From 13 and off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him.
You can just see the development of Lou Dort's game. Gets himself into that in-between area and makes it look easy.
One of the most team-friendly contracts in the league. Dort and I were just talking about this. Lou Dort, he's been a great deal for the Thunder.
Oh, my goodness. Under $2 million a year until the year 2023. Think about all he brings to this team. Once that contract expires, gentlemen, he's in for a big raise.
Second team foul.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter.
Boy, that's one he wishes he could have back, especially against soft defense.
Outside, George. There's Jackson with the three. Score of the basket, his third after five shots.
This guy is putting his fingerprints all over the game in this quarter. He has flat out dominated the offensive end.
And count it, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
What a pretty pass from Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. He's capable as a scorer, but finds his teammate there.
Oklahoma City shooting their first foul shot of the night. The Clippers trail. Jackson with it. He's got eight. Zubats in the post. Goes back up. Roby with the rebound. The Thunder have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Favors can't get it to go. And here's George. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. Batum wide open. He fires. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Yeah, really smart move by Paul George. Feeds a ready shooter instead of forcing his own shot.
They grab their own miss, and then Favors with the dunk.
That is a product of pure effort, guys.
I agree, and that's nothing new coming from him, GA. He loves going to work on the rebounding, going to work on the boards.
What about the decisive finish? Great timing, tremendous force.
And the Clippers have possession, following the score by Oklahoma City. Pass to Leonard. Let's it go with a three. The shot comes out. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing the last matchup with the Lakers.
Total embarrassment. I was shocked at how poorly they played. I think they were shocked.
Well, frankly, they should be shocked. I mean, that kind of effort simply won't cut it in today's NBA. Let's see if they take any lessons from it.
Tries from seven. And no good. Trying to use the glass.
Boy, what a job defensively. You couldn't play that any better.
Passes it to Leonard. Back to Jackson. Three-pointer. Roby with the rebound. Oklahoma City trailing. The dude passes to Favors. Up again. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Here's George. The Thunder pull it in.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
That's his second
person. The Thunder shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
Yeah, and over the course of the season, they're a respectable 78%. That comes in handy in close games.
That's good from the dude. Eric Bledsoe's checked in for Reggie Jackson. Both free throws good from the dude. Here's Bledsoe. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Pass to Zubats. Now Leonard. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. And that one is good from Zubats.
Well, as a great scorer, you still have to be willing to balance it with finding your teammates. Kawhi Leonard puts the ball where it needs to be.
Here's the dude. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Just focusing on the task at hand. That's all you can do.
Boy, the tide is running one way and then shifts back in the other direction. I've lost count of how many lead changes we've had here tonight.
Here's Bledsoe, the Thunder making the shot. Floats one up, and the rejection by Favors.
Derek Favors using that long frame to send that back twice on the pipes, Kevin.
And the shot goes in. Gilgeous Alexander's got his second bucket. And a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for the Thunder.
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots. A key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
There's something else they've done right from the get-go tonight is run. So much of their offense coming on the fast break.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Lopez, he's checked in for Zubats. And it's Ibaka in for Nicholas Batum. And a switch here also for Oklahoma City. Powell's checked in. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Steady offensive output from him, averaging more than 16 points a game. Oklahoma City shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight.
Shooting for Oklahoma City, number 69, two shots.
The first one falls. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Clippers trail by three. Out to Ibaka for the three. And the rebound goes to the Thunder.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
Los Angeles has gone 3-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. Bledsoe against Powell. Bledsoe passes to Leonard. Here's Lopez. That one doesn't go. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. To the paint. Here's Powell. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
The speed on the break from Powell right now. Just booking down the court and getting to the basket.
Now here is George. D right on him. Bledsoe right side. A steal. It's 2-on-1. Beasley passes to the dude. Driving inside. Not going to go that time. Excellent D there from George. Kicks to Ibaka. Back to George. Tries from 10. And the shot is long. Oklahoma City leading by five. Outside, Dort. The pass to the dude. And it's blocked by Ibaka.
Boy, great extension from Ibaka. His length always a factor.
Inside. Outside for Bledsoe. One. He takes it up and lays it in. Bledsoe's got five now.
You simply must put a body on this guy. You know he's going to try to get to that glass.
makes it 2 points there from the Dude, and the Thunder lead by five.
Well, they're leading in large part because of the work he's put in this quarter. This is nicely done.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's Leonard into the lane. Now in the scoring column with that bucket. 1 for 2 this game.
Kawhi Leonard able to navigate his way to the cup. Off the bounce, yes, sir.
No good from the Dude.
I'll tell you, it has not been this guy's best night, but the teammates have been there to pick up the slack. Love it. Well, the versatility he possesses makes him a very tough cover, guys.
Here's the Dude. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
Well, this has not been a quarter to remember for this guy. He looks completely flustered.
Here's Lopez. Banked in off the glass.
Well, this team likes to see Lopez working hard on the glass. That's a part of his game he must continue to improve upon.
Pass to the Dude. Boom, he jams it straight down. A lot of give and take between these sides early.
Yeah, and both teams look like they came to play. We should have a good one.
The Clippers trail.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
1:57 left to play in the first quarter. And George, here we go.
Well, you love how Paul George finishes on the drive. That is a powerful dunker right there.
Here's the Dude. Last game, an incredible scoring display for him. Out to the right wing. Giddy, the pass to the Dude. 5 to shoot. Here's Baisley. Oklahoma City moving the ball around. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Nobody near Leonard. And the three ball is good. And now a 4-point Clipper lead.
Boy, the range of Kawhi's shooting just keeps getting deeper and deeper. He really stretches you out.
Shot's good from the Dude.
Well, individually, he is doing everything he can in this 12-minute session, but he's just not getting enough help.
And here's George. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. He gets that one. Bledsoe's got his third basket of the night.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
For Oklahoma City, they haven't yet missed a free throw. 5 for 5. And he makes the first. Mann's checked in for Los Angeles. Luke Kennard comes in for George. The Thunder also changing it up. Okoshevsky's come in for Basin. And it's Williams in for George. And Doris, we know that Paul George has always been a solid passer, but his assist numbers have been trending up.
Yeah, he's been willing of late to take on more playmaking responsibilities. The skill set was there. It's just early in his career, they needed him to be the lead scorer. Now you're talking about a guy you've got to game plan against as a scorer and as a passer.
Shot clock at 2. A costly foul there. He'll shoot 3 free throws.
Well, an excellent free throw shooter. Luke Kennard is not the guy you want to send to the line.
For Los Angeles, they have gone 1 for 1, making their previous attempt at the line. That free throw, good from Kennard.
Well, shooting will always have its place in the modern NBA. Kennard, big-time value because he shoots at about 40% from deep.
Melodon's checked in for the Dude. Some changes. Zubac is checked in for Lopez. Leonard comes in for Serge Ibaka. And it's Paul George in for Luke Kennard. Passes it to the Dude. Goes to the reverse layup and traps it in. The Dude's got 21.
And the combination of his quickness and soft touch around the rim really allows him to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have the reverse in their arsenal.
So for Oklahoma City right now, sliding into the wing spot. Hilgeous Alexander and Dort. And it's the dude, and it's Baisley in at the four-man position. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hi, Kevin. Well, the dude in the last outing against the Lakers put on a show. He finished with 49 points, and his ability to keep getting back to the foul line helped their cause tremendously. When you look at the stat sheet, he was mind-blowing. It's hard to imagine he can follow it up tonight with that same level of production. Kevin, we'll see.
Thanks for the report, D.A. Greg, phenomenal effort by him in that last game.
He willed the team to victory through his talent and through that competitiveness.
Let's give credit to his teammates for continuing to find this guy. They knew he had the hot hand, and they were willing to ride it all night long.
No good from the dude. Los Angeles leading by 16. Bledsoe with it. He's picked up by Gilgeous Alexander.
Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Here's the dude, guarded by Bledsoe. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. George dishes to Lennon. Dort grabs the miss. Thunder trailing by 18. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
George going inside, and it's Paul George with the finish.
That is Paul George, the incredible vertical and the unbelievable creativity.
An outstanding defensive play to earn the Mobile One block.
And big defensive plays like that will help them stay in control of this one.
Here's Bledsoe. Nice. 4 for 7 from the floor with that shot.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder.
And we all know what George brings offensively. But it's his ability as a defender that stands out. Great instincts to make plays on that end of the floor.
Oklahoma City's gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter, only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. Gilgeous Alexander passes to the dude to stop the run. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Bledsoe's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And with Paul George and his defense, Greg, you almost forget how great of an impact it makes.
He just kind of flies under the radar with his defensive play. I mean, this guy could be considered for the Defensive Player of the Year almost every year. One of the more disruptive forces on that end of the floor.
And the foul on Isaiah Roby. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for 2. And this is his second trip to the line tonight.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
And Eric Bledsoe drops them both. And we all know that star players get a few more perks, but Greg, that can also stir up misgivings in a locker room when things aren't always equal.
Kevin, it's a great point, and coaches really have to be careful. If you're holding one player accountable and giving another a pass, that tends to lead to a fractured locker room.
Outside Leonard. Good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now, 6 for 8 on the night. And a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for the Clippers.
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots, a key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
And, you know, the other thing they've done really well tonight is stay active defensively. Lots of steals, and that's making a huge difference. When I think of Ivica Zubac, I think about solid big man who is still young and developing. It's really a matter of him gaining confidence at this point.
Goal for Zubac is to be a starter in the league.
You know, this guy has started games in the past. He's also played well off the bench. And listen, he's not going to be a guy who shoots with range. But given everything else you need from a center, he can deliver.
Lopez, he's checked in for Los Angeles. And both free throws good for Paul George.
Paul George, one of those players the media appreciates because he doesn't give you pat answers. When you ask him a question, he is thoughtful and is honest.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over.
Yeah, I think Coach calls his timeout right now because he's not happy with the distribution of shots. difficult shots, contested shots. You've got to get a better offensive rhythm.
Here's the Dude, guarded by Bledsoe. It's deflected, stolen by Bledsoe. Leonard, that's for two. Roby with the rebound. Roby's got eight rebounds in this game. Oklahoma City moving the ball around. The Dude passes to Gilgeous Alexander. To the inside, stolen by Bledsoe. To the middle, and Leonard gets it to go on the assist by Bledsoe. 16 points for Leonard.
And one of those nights where Kawhi Leonard just decides, I'm going to take over.
Here's the Dude. No good, unable to end this run.
No doubt the fight's there. They are trying to battle back, but he's just really struggling this quarter.
Roby with the rebound. Roby's got 9 rebounds now tonight. The shot by Beasley, no good.
Boy, you can just see the frustration growing on their faces. Nothing going their way.
It's just been one of those games that they need to find a way to turn it around before it gets completely away from them.
This is his third trip to the free throw line in the game.
How about the Kentucky team Eric Bledsoe was a part of? 8 future NBA players, including All-Stars John Wall and DeMarcus Cousins. An incredible group.
To the inside, the Dude, and a great assist by Gilgeous Alexander as that one goes in. And that's 23 points for the Dude. Here's Bledsoe. He's got 11. 51 seconds left to play here in the half. And that's collected by the Dude. Oklahoma City has gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter, only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. That one falls. The Dude's got 6 in the quarter.
Well, great decision from Dort. If your teammate is open, get him the basketball. Nicely done.
Bledsoe looking it over. Here's George. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. George has got 10 points in the game.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Down low, stolen by Zubats. And here we go. George heading to the hoop. And they pick up 2. He's got 12.
Oh, my goodness. Paul George under duress of exceptional defense. No problem.
Knocked away. Stolen by Bledsoe. And so it's Los Angeles with a massive lead of 30 points here at the end of the quarter. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We'll get right back to the action when we return. With a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Nice game, great performance by the Dude.
In that first half, he was a hot knife, and the defense was butter, sliced right through them.
His penetration was a real problem for them. And then, of course, the monster finishes at the cup.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade. For the second half of basketball. Setting the floor for the Clippers. The front court is Leonard and Batum. The guard spots filled by Jackson and George. And it's Zubats in at the 5, roaming the paint. Right side, Batum. Jackson with it. Dort covering. Here's Leonard. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. Leonard's got 18 points in the game. To the paint, here's the Dude. And a foul call. Almost got it to go in, Reggie, but he'll go to the line for 2.
That's his third personal
foul. That's on Reggie Jackson. The Thunder have gone a perfect 7 of 7 from the line tonight.
Number 69, 2 shots.
Both free throws good from the Dude. And a minute played as the second half gets going. And so George will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Outside Leonard. Now here's Zubats. Deflects the pass. Five on the clock. And it goes out of bounds. That one off George.
Yeah, gets a finger on it, but just can't quite come up with the steal.
But a really good read on his part, being disruptive at the defensive end right now.
Here's Zubats. He has six. Clock at four. And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
And Jackson certainly doesn't lack confidence. A speedy guard who can fill it up in no time.
It's his first trip to the line.
Jackson at the strike, taking two shots.
No good on that one. And the second free throw, good. The Thunder shooting 34% from the field. That's not going to get it done. Drives to the hoop. And the shot's good from the dude. The dude's got 29 in the game.
Terrific play call to give him a clean look at the rim. That's how you want to start the second half.
Well, there is nothing better than catching a rhythm as early as possible. And, boy, that's a terrific start right there.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Coming into last season, the Thunder had posted a winning record every year for more than a decade. But when they decided to rebuild, they went all in and promoted their G League coach, Mark Daigneault, to head coach. He said adversity tests the connection of the team. It tests everything. It shows you who you are. Guys?
Good way to start. Thanks, D.A. And the shot goes in from the dude. The dude's got 31 points.
He's shooting the lights out down the stretch, trying to keep them competitive.
And here is Los Angeles now. Outside Leonard. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. The Thunder pull it in. Here's the dude. He's got 31. Got a piece of it. George against Dort. Feeds it to Leonard. Now, Gilgeous Alexander. He's got 9. Driving to the basket. No good from the dude. For Los Angeles, they've gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. Leonard, the pass to Batum. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got 3 assists in the game.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
Outside Leonard. Here's Zubats, and the rejection by Favors over Roby. Missed it, even after all those chances. The dude passes to Roby. Oklahoma City moving it around, and he gets the bucket. And now that's 35 points for the dude.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
George against Gilgeous Alexander. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Greg, you know, you think back to when Gilgeous Alexander came to the Thunder, came over in that Paul George trade. He exploded after that deal.
And most of the focus on the picks the Thunder got, but Gilgeous Alexander has been the biggest return by far. Exploded once he arrived with the Thunder.
And here's George for 3. Number 12 goes in. He's made 7 of 12 now. And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Their defense has been outstanding, closing out on shots and blocking a few as well.
They've gotten out on the break over and over tonight as well. A lot of baskets coming in transition.
Substitution.
Oklahoma City going with a whole new group out there. Here's Jackson. 9 points in the game so far. Pass to Lopez. And Derek Favors picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him. And the Clippers making a change here. Zubats is checked in.
Now, into the lineup for your Clippers, Ivica Zubats.
Outside Jackson. Here he goes. And the layup's good off the glass. And that's 11 points for Reggie Jackson.
And good to see Jackson finish closer in. Not a guard who just chucks up threes, can find the creases with that handle.
Well, I'm telling you, this guy is doing everything he can to get them where they want to be. He's been on a mission in this period.
26 seconds left in the third. Gilgeous Alexander against George. There's 14 seconds left here in the third quarter. Zubac trying to break loose. George with the bucket. George has got 19 points.
That's what we call playing big. Paul George imposing his will in the paint.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Reggie Jackson. That's his fourth personal foul.
For Oklahoma City, they have an exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9.
Number 69.
That's good from the dude.
At the line for two.
Both free throws good from the dude. The three quarters of play all in the books, and this one all but over already. Los Angeles on top, opening up a huge gap. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
Dan, he's always been the favorite to bag this honor. These kind of feeds are his bread and butter.
Well, this is why great point guard play is so critical in today's NBA, and you see it right there on display.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. And Oklahoma City, look at who they've got to start the fourth quarter. Sliding into the wing spots, Gilgeous Alexander and Dort. And it's the dude, and it's Roby in at the five.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
George finds Johnson. Here's Hartenstein. Just 5 to shoot. The Clippers need to get off a shot. Johnson can't get it to go. Oklahoma City shooting struggles apparent. 37% from the field. The dude passes to Roby. Count that one.
Boy, when he's this deep, it's going to be tough to stop him, especially with a smaller defender.
And just a couple years ago, Doris, it seemed, didn't it, like bigs were a dying breed in the NBA. Then last season, two of the top MVP candidates were centers.
There was so much conversation that true five men, the center position, was no longer in vogue. And then all of a sudden, look what happens. Nikola Jokic and Joel Embiid were neck and neck for long stretches of the season. Both five men, both highly skilled. To me, it's always about, can you play the game or can you not play the game? And those two men, they can play. But he is so efficient, so productive. But for them to have real success, he needs help.
The Clippers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Preston passes to George. Here's Hartenstein. Lays it up off the glass.
Just the late reaction there from the defense, and he is always going to finish that one.
Here's the dude. And he converts
number
the layup.
59.
The dude's got 43 points.
He is just self-willing his team right now, doing everything he can to keep them alive.
The Clippers have gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. Here's Preston, and denied. He sends it right off the glass. And that one is good from Hartenstein.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
I can see the excitement with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, so young and yet so gifted as a passer.
Outside Leonard. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Roby's got 11 rebounds in the game. Robinson Earl. And that one drops.
Well, great possession there. Anytime you end up at the rim with a high percentage look, perfect.
Inside, here's Hartenstein, and down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
Sometimes a player is born with a passer's mindset. He deals it with conviction.
Here's the dude. Basket counts. The dude's got 47 points.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Here's Preston. The pass to Hartenstein. Pass to Preston. It's George on the wing. Here's Hartenstein. Pass to Preston. From past the arc. That one, no good. Down low. Here's the dude. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
Jeremiah.
49 points for the dude. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Preston passes to Hartenstein. George looking over the floor. And it's good for two. George has got 21 in the game.
How about the dribble drive ability of Paul George? The quick handles for a guy his size.
Outside, Dort. Gilgeous-Alexander passes to the Duke. And another one falls. Amazing. That gives him 51.
Making it look easy.
And here's George. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. And for top high schoolers, Doris, who want to make a salary instead of going to college, there are now quite a few options.
There are, Kevin, and I love it because to me, this is a free market system. So whether you're going overseas, you have the Ignite franchise in the G League. And listen, there may be more options to come, and I think that's a great thing.
No good from the dude.
Never easy to stop this guy at the rim, but that is a beautiful contest right there.
And it's Leonard missing. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Really getting it done. Dort against Leonard. Dort misses.
Boy, a little indecisive. I think he wanted to kick it out, changed his mind, and ended up missing.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Derek Favors checked in for Oklahoma City. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's Mobile One block?
And guys, that block could really help change the momentum of this game.
Jackson passes to Zubats. Back to Jackson. To the middle. Makes it off the glass.
That's the efficiency you want to see from Jackson, using his poise and vision to make a play.
Driving the lane. No good from the dude. Clippers have gone 7 of 13 from the field here in the fourth. Here's Batum. It's blocked. Gilgeous-Alexander against George. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Great player movement is always a constant in the NBA. But with more players on the move every year, the power balance can shift in the blink of an eye.
And we've seen it with the Lakers, right? Just a few years ago. The Nets and a few others. Not everyone, though, loves it. But it sure keeps things interesting.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Luke Kennard comes in for Leonard. Eric Bledsoe is subbed in for George.
Luke Kennard entered the league with a long history of success, both in the high school and collegiate levels. And this is a guy who I think still has a high ceiling.
So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
That's it, folks. The NBA regular season is in the books. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Ulmer, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for tuning in. So long.
It's that time of year again, my friends. My favorite time of the year, the NBA playoffs. Who wants the smoke? This is where legends are made. LeBron King James, Kobe Mamba Bryant, Michael Jeffrey Jordan, Larry Legend Bird. If you want to be an all-time great, you got to do it on the biggest stage, under the brightest lights, with the most pressure possible. That's what separates the good from the great, the real from the fake. If you're a fraud, you'll get exposed in the playoffs, point blank. Things get physical this time of year, and you get every team's best shot every single night. If this doesn't get your blood pumping, then you don't like basketball. Straight up, it's playoff time, baby. Let's get it.
Put some zeros in the bank. Show you how to make them pay attention when they ain't. Say what they gon' do, but they don't do it cause they can't. Make them bounce, rock, shake. Dance on a plate, call it strawberry cake. Try to set my plate, sorry you a little late. Tell them one time, baby, I don't like to wait. Wait, wake up, walk out fresh. New on deck, bust down Paget. Better have my check, better come correct. I might crush a mini me if I don't watch my stuff. I don't really know what you came for. I'm here to Millie double up, really stack my dough. Sky pulley up in the Ventador. Gotta send it like tic-tac-toe. I be laced up in Louis, just left from Gucci. Bougie and I'm choosy, ooh, ooh, ooh. Sit down in Prada, got it from my dada. Hustle like my mama, ooh, ooh, ooh. Make a bounce, rock, shake. I'ma show you how to put some zeros in the bank. Show you how to make them pay attention when they ain't. Say what they gon' do, but they don't do it cause they can't. Dance on a plate, call it strawberry cake. Try to set my plate, sorry you a little late. Tell him one time, baby, I don't like to wait. Wait. It's a tune-up, tune-up. Wrists on swim, I done blew up, blew up. Details, nice touch, so what? You can't yay me, I'm hard to interrupt. And anyway, like I was saying, when the bag match your words, you can tell that I ain't playing. Red carpet with a clutch, black card when I'm paying. Not too young to be a boss, top four, we'll be staying. I'll be laced up in Louis, just left from Gucci. Bougie and I'm choosy, ooh, ooh, ooh. Dip down in Prada, got it from my dada. Hustle like my mama, ooh, ooh, ooh. Make them bounce, rock, shake. I'ma show you how to put some zeros in the bank. Show you how to make them pay attention when they ain't. Say what they gon' do, but they don't do it cause they can't. Make them bounce, rock, shake. Hands on a plate, call it strawberry cake. Try to set my plate, sorry you a little late. Tell them one time, baby, I don't like to wait. Make them bounce. Make them bounce. Make them bounce. Make them bounce. Make them bounce.
Right here, duck down, stay low, my job, one punch KO. Tell her ain't no way I'm running now. Hard to catch me fumbling, jet black heart beneath that sundress. Sold out torpid stop in London town. Ain't no way I'm running now. Ain't no way I'm running. Yeah. Right here, duck down, stay low, my job, one punch KO. Tell her ain't no way I'm running. took a shot for the magazines, yeah. Another John Kennedy. Why so upset? I ain't never let him touch you. Got us in the flesh. Nope. Yelling, what's new, shawty? Don't wanna party. Meet me at the bottom. Buckle and break my hand. Hanging too tight. Down, stay low, my job. One punch KO. Tell her, ain't no way I'm running now. Ain't no way I'm running. Right here, duck down, stay low, my job. One punch KO. Tell her, ain't no way.
All right, check it out.